The wisdom of Lu Xun and the bravery of the Wu soldiers combined to defeat the enraged Liu Bei. Having lost the will to go on, Liu Bei fell ill and soon became unable to oppose Wu. And at the urging of Sun Shangxiang, he formed an alliance with them. Meanwhile, following the death of his father, Cao Cao, Cao Pi declared himself Emperor of Wei and moved to invade Wu. It was a sign of the threat that an alliance between Wu and Shu posed to his kingdom of Wei. Sun Quan himself led his troops onto the field and lay in wait for the impending battle at Dong Ko. Within the ranks of the Wei army was the feared General Zhang Liao. However, the old Sun Quan, who had cowered in fear before him at Hefei, was no more. Lu Xun, Ding Feng, Zhou Tai, Ling Tong, Lian Shi. The leader of Wu was surrounded by many brilliant young generals and courageous veterans. Brimming with confidence, Sun Quan boldly stepped forth onto the battlefield.
Sometimes it feels like I've spent my whole life just watching others. When my father and brother were alive, I used to resent the fact that all I was good for was watching them.
But not everyone can do that. It is your talent.
Yes, my sister and Zhou Yu said the same thing. I have come to realize that it is not so bad. With your help, we have been able to keep Wu safe.
My lord, you must never forget that it is your wisdom and vision that has kept us all safe.
It's very kind of you to say so.
My lord, preparations are complete. We await your orders.
Listen, men. We defeated the forces of Shu at Yiling. Now we must defeat Wei and prove we are the mightiest of the three kingdoms. That is the only way to bring peace to Wu and happiness to my people. Fight, soldiers of Wu, for our kingdom and for our families. Forward to glory! Tigers of Wu, it is time to show your fangs. You must fight for what is dear to our hearts.
So you are my next opponent. I'll crush you like all of you.
Thank you. Shun Twan, know that I will destroy the future of Wu. As commander of these forces, I will face you.